Hey guys, Yannick here for Cinecom.net and welcome back to another Copycat Friday. Everybody loves transitions, and so do we. That's why this week's video is perfect for all of us. We are going to recreate the reflection transition from Lady Gaga and Ariana's latest music video, Rain On Me. Here you can see Lady Gaga and Ariana dance in a futuristic city. But throughout the music video, they spin around into the reflection, creating a transition from one scene to another. And that's exactly what we are going to recreate today in Premiere Pro. Let's build the set!
So here we are, our own recreated skyline from the music video. And we kind of did that using these Spiffy Gear Speculars, which are kind of these bars of lights. You can connect them together, create your own shapes. We got some filters in front of them to kind of make that skyline on a budget. Now behind that, we got some black fabric, some curtains, which we've strewn over some racks. But behind those racks, we've got actually two aperture light storms, but again, a filter over them. And they're going to shine light, and because this room is filled with haze, they're going to reflect that light and we get that beautiful halo around the skyline. So what you now want to do is place your camera on a tripod in front of your actor, and you want to make it as wide shot as possible. And make sure that your dancer sits somewhere in the middle of the frame, because we're going to use the reflection on the ground to transition into. Now, super important is that your dance moves are going to be synchronized every time. So choose one dance and do that all over again with every shot that you want to take. Now, if you have trouble synchronizing that, you can also shoot at 60 frames or even higher, and then you can kind of time remap your dance moves to synchronize them better. You don't really have to move lights around. What we just did was change the filters to have a different color. So we go from a warm tone scene into a cold blue tone scene. That's pretty much it. And to top it off, we're gonna work with rain. Now you don't have to work with that, but of course a watery floor is gonna help with that reflection more. And it's just way cooler. So what we did was actually work with real water. That way we kind of have this interaction on the floor whenever the dancer is doing his moves. You can also do that in post-production, but it will never be as real unless you put like a lot of time and effort into it. But that's pretty much it. Do be careful though, if you're gonna work with real water, the floor can get slippery.
Jill, Jill, Jill. However, before we start with our post-production, I would first like to talk about our sponsor, Storyblocks Video. This huge online stock website is a filmmaker's best friend. They are always here to help you. Like for instance, transitions. If you are looking for some cool instant transitions, then Storyblocks Video is the place to be. But they have more, like lens flares, light leaks, green screenshots, 4K stock clips, super easy to customize After Effects templates, and I can keep on going. But I'm not here to bore you with that. I'm just gonna say, if you pay one single price per year, you can download an unlimited amount of video assets. As much as you want. Heck, you can even download the whole library. So don't wait and start downloading from Storyblocks Video by clicking the first link in the description below. Now let's start with our post-production. First thing we are going to do is create a sequence, but we are going to make the sequence a little bit higher than the normal 69. This is because we are going to stack our clips underneath each other and we need some room. Then place a clip on track number 1. Take your second clip and place this on top on track number 2. Sync these two clips, but because it's near impossible to match them completely, as your dancer isn't a robot, just do it as good as possible. You can even see in the music video from Lady Gaga and Ariana that they also don't sync up completely. So don't worry if your footage won't sync up that well. Now take the clip on track number 2 and rotate it 180 degrees. Move it down and create a feathered mask around your actor. You will now have a reflection, but a normal reflection isn't that hard. So lower the opacity to around 50 and also flip the clip horizontal. You can easily do this with the horizontal flip effect. Now let's also add a small distortion to the reflection clip. Add the turbulent displays effect to the reflection and you can already lower the amount and size of the effect. Then of course animate the evolution so that you have some motion in the effect and mimic the rain hitting the floor. It's already starting to look good. So now we can start with the transition. first pick a point where the transition needs to start. Here you can make a cut in the layer on track number 1. Then take the part behind the cut and place it on track number 3. Next up is the animation of the opacity of the reflection, so the clip on track number 2. Let this gradually go from 50 to 100, starting before the cut and ending behind the cut. Also animate the turbulent displays to fade out. Then on the point where we made a cut, enable the animation for the mask pad. Go one frame further in time and open up the mask, revealing the rest of the clip. Now create a feathered mask on the clip from track number 3. Again, only mask what you want as a reflection. Also add a turbulent displays effect to this clip. The turbulent displays needs to be animated in to reveal itself. When you have done that, you get something like this. Looks finished, no? Well, no. But we are getting close. The next step is nesting all the layers. A good tip before we nest everything, place a marker on the cut that we made previously. This will help us remember where that cut was later on. Then change the sequence settings for our first sequence to a normal 69. Look for the transform effect and drag that to the nested sequence. Step 1, set the anchor point of the transform effect on the right spot, just between the reflection and the original clip. Position and scale your clip however you want, go to the marker and the place where we made a cut before. Here our transition needs to be, so go a couple of frames back in time and enable the animation for the position, scale and rotation. Then go further in time, past our marker and let the clip zoom in and rotate. You of course need to use a position property to maintain the right framing. What we also did was adjust the framing in the middle of the animation. Most of the time the framing will be off, but you can easily adjust it with the position. Now for some fine tuning. Of course make the keyframe smooth. And you can also play around with keyframe curves to really make the transition as smooth as possible. Now one last thing, disable the use composition shutter angle and set the shutter angle to 180 degrees. This will give you motion blur and finish the effect. Now you can do whatever animation you want. Go up, down, spin it around 10 times, it's your choice. But this is the principle on how you do it. It's time for a GenX Fun Fact Fountain! When I hear transitions, I think about Star Wars and their iconic wipes. Of course, I did some research, and apparently George Lucas really, really loves his transitions. In The Revenge of the Sith, he used 102 transitions. That's a lot of wipes for one movie. And not just normal wipes from one side to another, no. He had some really weird transitions going on. Like you can see in this beautiful infographic. Infographics, they are the best. And that was it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope you learned something new. Thank you Storyblocks Video for the support. And like always, stay creative.
I hurt myself today to see if I'd still feel. I focus on the pain.